commitments to support the cause of democracy throughout the world won him acclaim almost unprecedented in the history of the presidency. He faced up to communist threats with such firm shows of force that Khrushchev backed down in Cuba, softened the hard red line on Berlin. He brought to the White House the vigor of youth and a family that captivated the hearts of all. No possible shadow loomed over this last group picture of his family, John and Jacqueline, John and Caroline. Death has closed the cover and album portraits like this. His rendezvous with grim destiny begins a little after noontime as his plane lands in Dallas. Earlier, he had received a tumultuous reception in Fort Worth. Now, more thousands are waiting to greet him in downtown Dallas. But death is less than one short hour away. At 1:25, the motorcade moves into the downtown area. Death is 6 minutes away. In a warehouse, a sniper with a rifle poised waits. The cheers of the crowd almost muffle the three shots. The assassin's aim is deadly. The area is a swarm with police, rangers, and Secret Service men. The murderer slips the net, but a few blocks away, a man is captured after he is reported to have killed a policeman. That man is a 24-year-old pro-Castro Texan who once sought Soviet citizenship. He is charged with murder. Meanwhile, the president had been rushed to a nearby hospital where life lingered as a waiting world prayed. A half hour later, he was dead.
We'll be right back. Thank you.